हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू स्पाइस धमाल। होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग एब्सोल्युटली फाइन। आशा करता हूँ आप सब लोग मजे में रहेंगे। एंड हियर आई एम बैक अगेन विद अनदर रेसिपी। आई एम योर होस्ट नितिन, एंड स्पाइस धमाल इज अ चैनल वेयर वी डू फंटास्टिक रेसिपीज, सिंपल रेसिपीज विच यू कैन इजिली ट्राई एट होम। सो इफ यू लाइक द रेसिपी, मेक श्योर यू प्रेस द थंब आइकॉन एंड सब्सक्राइब टू अवर चैनल टू ग्रो दिस फूडी कम्युनिटी इफ यू हैवंट सब्सक्राइब्ड येट। And I must thank you all for the phenomenal response which you gave for my continental European recipes. We did some nice chicken recipes. Today is going to be another classic recipe across USA, Europe. This is known as a comfort food, or some people call this a food for kids as well. But it is so classic, all ages love it. And the name of the recipe is mac and cheese. So macaroni pasta cooked in cheese sauce. We're going to nicely put a cheese on top and grill it in the oven as well, so it's going to be super delicious. So let us see what all you need for this recipe. So this amazing mac and cheese, what you need obviously is the macaroni or a mac. So these are elbow pasta which we have boiled and kept. So this is around raw weight of around 250 gram to 300 gram. So we have boiled it for 10 minutes and drained the water and kept it ready. We will be using around 50 gram of butter, 2 tablespoon of flour to make the white sauce or cheese sauce. We will flavor it with garlic and onion, though this is optional. We will add little bit of mixed herbs as well to give it a flavor. But what is mac and cheese without good quality cheese? So we will be using some mozzarella. So this is 100 grams of mozzarella, and we will grate the cheddar cheese on top before grilling. You need around 500 ml of milk and some black pepper. So simple recipe, and it's a vegetarian recipe as well. So you can make this base pasta, and depending on your choice, you can add the protein to it. So let's start cooking. So for our mac and cheese, first thing is to make the cheese sauce. So the base is, you make a white sauce with butter and flour. So the pan is moderately hot. We will put our butter in first. Some people use olive oil, but I prefer in mac and cheese, butter works well because we are not adding cream in this recipe. So butter gives that nice and velvety rich feel. So once your butter is moderately hot, first thing which we will add is the dried herbs, so they can impart their flavor to butter and our sauce also gets good flavor. We'll add little bit of crushed pepper at this stage as well. The flame needs to be moderate, otherwise butter can burn and spoil the color of your sauce. So let's add garlic. This is little bit, around 2 to 3 cloves of garlic, and gently saute it till you get the flavor of garlic. Wow, that smells delicious. Now we will add the onion. Now you will notice here I have use the white onion for this recipe because I don't want it overpowering. It just mild flavor we want. So we have used a white onion in this recipe. Let us saute this for 1-2 minutes on a low heat. Our onion and garlic is sauteed. The raw flavor is gone and they have become slightly soft. So this is the time we add the refined flour or maida. So this is 2 tablespoons of maida. Need to cook it with butter well. So as soon as you add the maida, this is in continental cuisine or a European cuisine, the stage is known as making a roux. So for this recipe we are making a light roux. So we have to gently cook the maida or refined flour. this takes hardly 30 to 45 seconds. Now to this we will slowly start incorporating the milk to create our white sauce. So on a low heat you add little bit of milk and with a whisk you start mixing it so that the lump doesn't form. So as soon as it starts to cook you add little extra milk. So I have taken around 500 ml of milk. You have to always use cold milk for this recipe. Cold or a room temperature milk. Now as soon as this batch cooks, we will add some more milk. And you have to keep on stirring so that the lump doesn't form. So the sauce is starting to become nice, shiny and velvety. Now it's time to add more milk. Now this is the basic white sauce recipe is used in lot of European cuisines. So you can, I'm using macaroni in this, but you can add any other pasta also. So this sauce is thickened. Let's add the final batch of milk. So since I am showing you recipe on YouTube, I am adding batch by batch. The chefs who have experience in making this, they just do it in few minutes on a high flame. But it's better you work on slow flame so the sauce doesn't stick to the pan and you keep on stirring till you get the nice consistency of the sauce. Now slowly you will see the sauce is starting to thicken. That's the time we will add the cheese. So far we have not added salt also to this because our butter was salted. Also we have boiled the pasta in salt and cheeses also have a bit amount of salt in it. So you can adjust the salt towards the end, otherwise your mac and cheese becomes salty. As you can see the sauce is starting to simmer and it started thickening. So it's time to add the mozzarella cheese to the sauce. Now why I use mozzarella is, mozzarella gives nice stringy consistency when you eat. And that is quite delicious and tasty. So let us incorporate our mozzarella cheese in the sauce. You have to keep it on a low flame always. You see nice cheesy sauce is forming. You see nice stringy consistency is coming to the sauce. Now it's time you give it a quick test if you want to add salt. I think little bit of salt will go now. And it's time to add the pasta to the sauce. Let us add the pasta slowly in batches. Wow, that looks nice and cheesy. Let's add the next batch. At this stage, you have to keep the flame slow. Unlike other pasta dishes, we are going to finish this in the oven with the cheddar cheese on top. So on a slow flame, you just have to mix this well. And if you feel the sauce is little extra dry, you can add little bit of milk. But I think for me, this looks quite fine right now. Nice and cheesy sauce. See how the strings are coming of mozzarella. That's how you want your mac and cheese to be. Once we bake, it will be even nicer. Now switch off the flame. Now the next step is to layer the pasta in a baking tray or a pie dish and then putting the cheese on top, the grating the cheese on top so that we are using cheddar there and then grilling it or baking it in oven for around 20 minutes. So I have got a nice baking tray. I have just lined it with some butter. Let us add our pasta. Now what this does is, if you use a flat tray like this, the surface area is more, so the top layer of cheese get distributed everywhere, and then everybody who is getting a portion of this delicious mac and cheese will have the part of that crusted cheese also. So let's spread it out like this. Wow, this reminds me my days in London. We used to cook trays and trays of this for a lot of parties and functions. So now it's time to put the layer of grated cheese on top. So I've got some beautiful cheddar cheese. So we're going to make a nice layer on top. Wow, that looks delicious. So now this tray is going to go in a preheated oven for around 20 minutes at around 200 to 225 degrees Celsius. First for 10 to 12 minutes we will let it bake like that, and then we will put the grill setting and put the heat on top to make the nice brown crust. So our super delicious mac and cheese is ready. It's such a delicious and yummy looking recipe. I know all my family members are going to be very happy, especially the kids. So I'm going to test and show you how it is. But before that, see this nice crust of cheese on top and nice cheesy elbow pasta or macaroni in cheese sauce inside. So take bit of crust and bit of pasta and taste it. So that is steaming hot. Delicious and cheesy. The only word describes to this pasta is cheesy. I hope you like the mac and cheese recipe. If you like the recipe, make sure you press the thumb icon. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe so that we can grow this foodie community. Do let us know in comment box if you prepared this recipe, how it came out, or any other recipes you would like to see. We will definitely try to accommodate on the channel. And until we meet again with such a delicious recipes, stay happy, stay healthy, and enjoy cooking.